party have, we had to buy this party, and they're the only ones that don't know it's a pool party. Ha. So I hope they're excited about this. I do want to start with a little bit of music. Do you mind if we start with the music and then we repeat the same music until everyone gets here?
Oh, I'm
all through my home.
Come on.
I'm only singing because Casey's on. Joanna's not dancing, forget it.
Oh yeah, I like the glasses. Okay. Woo. Get those glasses on, guys. To be the star of this party, since you paid all the big bucks for this, can you please give me the name of a song that you like? I know I can't stop the feeling. You have anything else?
Just keep it like that, Mrs. Ferguson. You're good. I like the upside down view of myself.
I know. I kind of liked it too, but I don't want to mess up Ms. Bannon's party.
Exactly. Oh, no, we would never do that to you.
All right.
Okay.
I need to get my shades.
If you happen to have a towel and sunglasses, is everyone ready? Plus, you need a good attitude and you have to want to have fun. We're going to first start off with grabbing a snow cone.
First thing we're going to do, blow some snow. After we get some snow, I like to go with some cherry. I like to use blue raspberry. And then I like to hit it with ice cream. Important thing to remember about making a rainbow snowball. You gotta have red, yellow, and blue. So it helps if you let me know what red you like, whether it be cherry or strawberry. What yellow you like, whether it be banana, ice cream, pineapple. And what blue you like. Me, I like blue raspberry, but you can use blue bubble gum. Pretty good too. Look at the cone on that snowball. Gonna put a little trench in it just to keep from making a mess here. Now, here we go. Making the perfect rainbow snowball, always start with yellow right down the middle. There we go. Now let's throw our cherry for some red. On the port side, let's throw some blue on the starboard side. That, ladies and gentlemen, is a rainbow snowball. Just look at it. Wow, the texture of the ice, the snow, it's just amazing. Oh yeah. Oh.
Okay, guys, did you enjoy your snow cone? Thumbs up. Okay, Megan, Monica, you're going to invite your friends to play a memory game. So I am going to I need to get out of presentation view here because it won't let me move.
Six.
Oh, no. And let's see who else. Juliana, what do you think? And Abigail will go after that. And
am I supposed to do it?
Yeah, me too.
I can't. And 12.
9 and 12. Cha-ching! Boy, she's really good. Okay. Cha-ching! And now, Isabella, which ones do you think?
Isabella. 15.
And 3. Miss Lucas?
Is there a pattern?
Miss Lucas? Piper, Miss Lucas, you want to go next?
Piper.
Who wants to go? Megan? Kate? Monica?
Kate.
I'll go.
Okay, tell me which ones to move.
I'll go. Okay, tell me which ones to move.
After this game, we're going to do a water slide, then a scavenger hunt. Okay. Which one should I move, guys?
Okay. Which one should I move, guys?
Miss Reisinger, what do you think?
Miss Reisinger, what do you think?
Try moving 17.
17.
Try moving 17.
14.
And what other one? What do y'all think?
Somebody said 14. I think that's a good idea.
14?
Yeah, 14.
Yay! Cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching.
There we go.
Okay. Help me. Y'all can all call it out. Anyone can. What number should I move?
2.
10.
2 and 10. 2. You still think I should move 10?
16.
No. 4.
5. 16 and 5. Cha-ching! What do you think matches next?
8 and 11.
8 and 11. You are so right. Okay, which 1 and 4? 4 and what?
Yeah.
1 and 4.
1 and 4. Oh, yeah. Okay.
We saw the pattern.
What's next?
7 and 10.
7, 10. Woo! And we all know what goes next.
16 and 13.
You are so good, guys. I've got to get this done. Yeah. A bunch of people did. So here we go.
No.
No. You have 1 minute. I'm going to go get the timer. And you have 1 minute to find the things. Let me go get the timer. Oops, wait. I'm going to exit a towel. So you keep that in front
of me. And I'm at the table.
Table. Super cool. Now you're the next person to tell everyone. I have a coaster.
Mine's a CD case.
A CD case?
Oh.
Okay. Yep. Anyone have anything else?
A pillow.
A pillow. It's soft and smooth.
This is smooth for some reason. It's like soft.
Okay, the next thing, find something that begins with the letter S. Ready, set, go.
Sunglasses.
Sunglasses. Bridges. Yum. A sponge.
Spaghetti.
That's cool. Okay, ready for the next one?
Yeah.
Find something soft. Well, we kind of already did that.
Soft. Find something soft.
Pillow.
A blanket.
Pillow, a blanket.
Blanket.
Megan, I can't even see you. Put your video on, guys. I can see all of you. Can't see everyone. Show yourself so I can see what you're bringing. Let's see who else is coming. Okay. Find something that is blue. A cup.
This is all I can find. It's technically blue.
Recycling bin.
And
crayon. A blue purse.
It's a Bannon.
Purse.
Miss a blue Bannon, recycling bin. Lego piece.
You got a blue Lego piece?
Yeah.
A blue Lego piece?
Yeah. A blue Lego piece.
What else do we have?
What else do we have?
Blue. Okay, ready for the next thing? Find something that begins with H. Ready, set, go.
Hair.
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 Hat.
Hat.
Hair.
H.
Hair.
Hair. Here. Need your videos on so we can see, Casey. Megan.
Okay, I couldn't find anything.
A headband?
Miss Lucas, we need your video on a headband. That's a good one. Here. Headband, hat. Okay, let's see what the next one is. Oh, the next. Everyone, look at the screen. Thank you. Diving in the pool. Jack, turn your camera on so I can see you. One, two, three,
okay.
Four.
How five. Do I do this?
Diamond, what? Six, eight, 10 jumping jacks. 8, 9, 10.
I'm not helping you.
Simon says hop on 1 foot until Simon says stop. Simon says, hop on 1 foot until Simon says, stop. Stop. Simon says, march in place until Simon says, stop.
Yeah, I can't get this page though.
Simon says, jog in place until Simon says, stop. Stop. Simon says, take 5 deep breaths. Simon says, do you know what a burpee is?
Yeah.
Do two. Let's see you do it, Casey. Let's see you do a burpee, Sarah.
What?
Let's see you do a burpee, Monica.
I don't know what that is.
Watch Monica.
Wait.
Jump up high. Watch Monica jump up high, then go down. Does it?
And I can't see this screen.
You can see Monica. She jumps up high.
Okay, no.
I can't see this screen.
What is this?
Monica, she jumps up high.
I can't see her screen.
Oh, okay. Okay, let's see what else Simon says to do. Oh, does anyone have to book the rainbow? That's going to be fun. Are you ready?
Hello, my reading friends. It's Ani. Go to Iba Wasim in North Dakota, Tia in Maryland, Urihan in New Jersey, Nuseba and Abdullah in South Africa, and Lavana and Joanna in China. Hello, my reading friends around the world. What a great big reading family we have. Are you ready for a story? Today we're going to read about a fish. Very special that the other fish would share. Let's see what happens as we read The Rainbow Fish. If you have a copy, go get it so you can read along with me. The Rainbow Fish by Mark, translated by J. Allison King. A long way out in the deep blue sea, there lived a fish. Not just an ordinary fish, but the most beautiful fish in the entire ocean. His scales were every shade of blue and green and purple, with sparkling silver scales among them. The other fish were amazed at his beauty. They called him Rainbow Fish.
Come on, Rainbow Fish,
they would call.
Come and play with us.
But the Rainbow Fish would just glide past, proud and silent, letting his scales shimmer. One day, little bluefish followed after him.
Rainbowfish, he calls, wait for me. Please give me one of your shiny scales. They are so wonderful, and you have so many.
You want me to give you one of my special scales? Who do you think you are? Cried the rainbow fish. Get away from me. Shocked, the little bluefish swam away. He was so upset, he told all his friends what had happened. From then on, no one would have anything to do with the rainbow fish. They turned away when he swam by. What good were the dazzling, shimmering scales with no one to admire them? The loneliest fish in the entire ocean. One day, he poured out his troubles to the starfish. I really am beautiful. Why doesn't anybody like me?
I can't answer that for you, said the starfish. But if you go beyond the coral reef to a deep cave, you will find the wise octopus. Maybe she can help you.
The rainbow fish found the cave. It was very dark inside and he couldn't see anything. Suddenly, two eyes caught him in their glare and the octopus emerged from the darkness.
I have been waiting for you, said the octopus with a deep voice. The waves have told me your story. This is my advice. Give a glittering scale to each of the other fish. You will no longer be the most beautiful fish in the sea, but you will discover how to be happy. I can't,
the rainbow fish started to say, but the octopus had already disappeared into a dark cloud of ink.
Give away my scales? My beautiful shining scales? Never! How could I ever be happy without them?
Suddenly, he felt the light touch of a fish. The little fish was back.
Rainbow fish, please don't be angry. I just want one little scale.
The rainbow fish wavered.
Only one very, very small shimmery scale, he thought. Well, maybe I wouldn't miss just one.
Carefully, the rainbow fish pulled out the smallest scale and gave it to the little fish.
Thank you! Thank you very much!
The little blue fish bubbled playfully as he tucked the shiny scale in among his blue ones. A rather peculiar feeling came over the rainbow fish. For a long time, he watched the little blue fish swim back and forth with his new scale glittering in the water. The little blue fish whizzed through the ocean with his scale flashing. So it didn't take long before the rainbow fish was surrounded by the other fish. Everyone wanted a glittering scale. The rainbow fish shared his scales left and right, and the more he gave away, the more delighted he became. When the water around him filled with glimmering scales, he at last felt at home among the other fish. Finally, the rainbow fish had only one shining scale left. His most prized possessions had been given away, yet he was very happy.
Come on, rainbow fish,
they called.
Come and play with us.
Here I come, said the rainbow fish, and happy as a splash, he swam off to join his friends. Rainbow fish learned that when he shared his most prized possession, it made him feel happy. I think his scales could represent more than just objects.
He can. Bye, guys. I'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.